It is a great pleasure to have you at ISG Delft.
Thank you very much for the invitation. For me, it is really a pleasure to be here.
How has changed Delft and ISG Delft since your time as participant and now?
Almost 38 years ago, I was in this room taking my oral examination. I took the one course, which was a one-year course, specialization on sanitary engineering. I'm very happy to see that the atmosphere is the same. At my time as a student, it was an opportunity that opened myself to the world, get in contact with an international view, people from Africa, Asia, Latin America, etc. And it remains the same. I come here every year as a guest lecturer. I find more or less the same people. So I think IHG was able to keep this warm atmosphere, international sense of looking at sanitation and water that really makes me very enthusiastic.
Marcos, your academic career is impressive. You have more than 100 publications, several prototypes, several pilot plants, patents, moreover 23 books in Portuguese and English, including some of the most influential textbooks in wastewater treatment that initially were published in Portuguese and later released under the Creative Commons license at IWA WaterWiki to make them fully open access. What inspired you to take such a decision to make all your books open access?
Okay, I think we're made of opportunities. And I think a book, literature, relevant to our area is an opportunity we receive from other people and we have to give to other people. We started our experience in producing books in Brazil, and we made a very cheap format, and we're selling very much. Almost all the universities there in Brazil were adopting our books. Then we put the books at IWA Publishing. But the international market is different, so the costs were very high. And then I thought I would like these books to be reachable in the developing world. Then I negotiated with IWA Publishing, and it was one of the first experiments of IWA Publishing to make the books open access.
In Brazil, at UMFG and in a few wastewater treatment plants, your research group, your department, you have an impressive number of prototypes installed to test and study these systems using real wastewater. Perhaps you have one of the first and the largest locations in Latin America to do this type of research. What is your advice to the new generations of scientists and researchers that want to take their ideas, that want to take their innovations from lab to full scale? In what they need to endure, in what they have to be patient, in what they have to be flexible?
Okay. Very important point. We started with our prototypes, our experimental treatment plant, in 2002. And together with Carlos Chanicharo, who is also a guest lecturer here at IHG, so he works mainly with anaerobic treatment, I'm covering natural treatment systems, and then I think we matched very, we complement each other very much. We have at the beginning, we got some subsidy, some funding from the Brazilian research program on basic sanitation, which was a landmark in Brazil because this program put universities and water and sanitation companies working together. So not universities working separately, but as a network. And as part of this network, we started with our experimental treatment plant. And it was growing little by little. Then we were able to get funding here, funding from another agency there. So when you ask advice to other people who would like to replicate this, it is always difficult to give advices. But in our case, we made a stepwise increase. We started small, we increased little by little, because it is very difficult in our reality for you to start with the bigger things. And I think it would be the same when you ask it about how to change from lab scale to full scale. We have to move lab scale, and then a prototype in which you are subject to pipes blocking, pumps breaking, electricity faults, and so on. Because then you're approaching real life. Then if you move into this, so lab scale, controlled conditions, excellent experiments, but then you move to something more challenging at this point. And then until you have a proven technology, you are able to apply on a full scale. And, well, I think we all have to be persistent.
Now, if we move to the other side of innovation, on the one hand, we have the researchers, we have the scientists. But You, together with Professor Carlos Chernicharo, you are what I called, in my opinion, a special type of professors, because you are able to combine practice, science, and technology, for example, by taking part in design of several wastewater treatment plants in Brazil, including one of the largest anaerobic plants in the world, ONSA, with an installed capacity of 1.3 million people, also the plant in Arudas, where you have this research center. What can you tell the engineers to do, to consider, to facilitate the adoption of innovative technologies and practices in the water field?
I think we have to be open-minded, because there are so many technologies available. We should not close to, I like this technology, I hate this one. There is no room for this anymore. All of them have their applicability. So I think we, in the water and wastewater sector, those working at water and sanitation companies, water utilities, they have to be open-minded. Let's see what technology best fits each condition, because they are always site-specific.
Something that has always struck me, and I have asked you several times, is that you did your PhD on activated sludge.
Yes.
Aerobic system. But you are expert in ponds, in natural systems, with several books and publications. And for some people, this is to some extent a career change. What led you to change your track?
Maybe it's not so much as a career change, but it's a focus change. And I like the idea of knowing that we have so many possibilities for treating wastewater, and all of them are good. I think we have to make the best possible use of all the possibilities. Activated sludge, many people say, well, don't apply it. But in some cases, yes, in my city we have an excellent activated sludge treatment plant. In other cases, wetlands. In other cases, anaerobic treatment. In other cases, ponds and so on. And as I said, they are always site-specific. We are fortunate to have so many opportunities to select the best possible treatment we have for each situation.
Circular economy, climate change, global warming, all these are hot topics. Some of them are more popular than the others. How do you expect that the water sector, and in particular the wastewater sector, will evolve?
Well, I come from a developing country, and it is a challenge for us, because we still have to solve the basic things from the past, which are still unsolved in terms of water supply, in terms of sanitation, and so on. And this is similar to many students we have here at this institute. At the same time, we're being faced with the new challenges which are approaching. I think we need to give priority. We will not be able to tackle all of them. We have to be open-minded, be prepared, and adapt ourselves little by little to all these new changes.
What can you advise the current participants and even the recent graduates of ISG Delft to do and what not to do to have a successful and fruitful career?
Study with passion, be good students. Then when you finish, work with passion, be good workers in the field you have selected. And what they shouldn't do, oof, that would be a difficult question. I think they should start with what they need to do. I think they'll be happy if they do what they need to do.
Marcos, it has been a pleasure to have you.
Thank you very much, Carlos. It was really a pleasure for me. I'm very happy with the opportunity you have given me.